in many education institutions across the world, and with many institutions in India and abroad, multiple organizations, disciplines, and also during my course I took in various in India and abroad. And I am happy to present you the award, what is called a distinct profile for the nation of the world in 2030 as follows. By 2030, another 8 years time, how this world should look like, we have visualized. And they have let me present with the visualization. First of all, a world of nations, where divide between rural and urban, rich and the poor, development and developing has narrowed. A world of nations, where there is equitable distribution and adequate access to energy and quality water. A world where core competencies of each nation are identified. Missions synergizing the core competencies of different nations lead to economic advantage and fast development for all the society. World of nations where all the students of all the societies are important in education with values. A world of nations where affordable quality healthcare is available to all. A world of nations where the governance is responsible, transparent and corruption-free. A world of nations where crimes against women and children are absent and none in the society feels alienated. A world in which every nation is able to give clean, green environment to all its citizens. A world that is prosperous, healthy, secure, devoid of terrorism, peaceful and happy, and continues the sustained growth path. A world of nations with creative leadership, with them who ensure effective mechanisms to resolve conflict between the nations and societies in a timely manner, keeping overall peace and prosperity of the world as a whole. These are the 10 missions. Now we need out of ideas needed for the Asia Pacific region. Dear friends, Asia Pacific region today represents about 3 out of every 5 human beings in the planet. Moreover, the region has a high concentration of youth of the world and is rich with great tradition, culture and religions. At the same time, because of the high population, the region is also marked by low per capita resource availability, which necessitates focus on the efficient, eco-friendly management of resources. Many of the nations in the region are within the tropics and near the coast, which makes them vulnerable to the changing climatic condition as you are, both in terms of habitat variation and natural calamities. Moreover, they have a high rural population percentage, mainly involved in agriculture activities. About 40% of the total employed workforce, the region would represent an emerging economy, also has the advantage of challenges of overcoming poverty, inequity and societal disparities, which are more than other regions in the world. Thus, with such a human resource of opportunity, how can we empower the people of Asia Pacific region with economic prosperity and security, peace and harmony? This will be the most vital question to address in our first year at the World Vision 2030. We will be needing a system of sustainable development for international rural community worldwide, out of which more than 2/3 are in Asia Pacific region, will be the basis of our discussion further. One such system, the empowerment, is that of Pura are providing urban amenities in the rural area. Yesterday evening, I visited the parliament, Bangladesh parliament, and also I met your honorable Prime Minister, Sheikh Hasina. Also, what we need is innovative technologies which match the market. Yesterday I met with Prime Minister of Bangladesh, Honorable Sheikh Hasina, and also visited the Parliament of Bangladesh. The Prime Minister mentioned her vision for prosperous and happy Bangladesh. She said that Bangladesh people are consumers of fish and rice. We are also in India also like that. Bangladesh people are consumers of fish and rice. So she started a customizing agriculture accordingly. By research and technology implementation, there has been a mass movement towards growing paddy and fish in the same form At the same time, this how technology is not only enhancing the production, but also meeting the market needs and enriching the farmers. Today, one of the major problems in the field of agriculture in the region is small size land holding by farmers, which continuously getting fragmented due to our family structure. Under these circumstances, only solution for increasing the productivity is to create a positive farm cooperative movement in our rural sector, which will bring together small farmers facilitating mechanized farming, silo storage, value addition, and marketing of agro products. I have come across situation where farmers' production increasing with vegetables and fruits, all the MSP-supported crops met with market crashes and failures. We have to find solution to the problem through farmers' cooperative movement. When the farmers' production increases, these cooperatives will forecast and establish networks with the market on behalf of the individual farmer members to facilitate their rapid movement from farm gate to optimal shelves according to the nation and the world. Also, the entrepreneurs should plan for diversification and value addition of the product needed by various sections of the society. Recently, during my visit to agriculture laboratory in Hyderabad, in South India, I saw hybrid variety of a corn seed which increased the productivity by 10 times. With this background, I would like to ask a question: can a farmer get transformed into entrepreneur? In the first green revolution in our country, the task of farmer was to increase the agricultural produce of grain based on seed to crop. Second green revolution, which we are launching, which has to be for the entire region of Asia Pacific, but I visualize, we have to go for soil matching with seeds, precision farming till harvest and post-harvest operation, followed by improved storage, value addition, processing, and marketing the product as a food. For all these options to take place economically with high productivity, we have to empower the farmers with cooperative societies as participating establishments. The agriculture education system for the scientists, the extension workers, and farmers should highlight this thinking in their syllabus. This will be strategy through which we can empower the farmer as an entrepreneur and enhance the productivity of the agriculture sector. In view of achieving sustainable development system in our rural complexes, we need Pura. Pura means providing adequate amenities to rural areas, which envisages four types of connectivity. As you see there, four types of connectivity, namely physical connectivity, electronic connectivity, and knowledge connectivity, leading to the economic connectivity of the complex. Such Pura is driven by rural entrepreneurship and becomes the growth center for the entire region. Let's look at what is Pura connectivities, what are the connectivities. Pura essentially requires four levels of connectivity, as I said, which have to be customized according to the local competencies and needs. It may be a fisherman village, or an agriculture village, or a craftsman village, or a tourist village. So the connectivity, what does it mean? The villages must be connected within themselves, and the main towns and metros through the good roads and whatever needed by railway lines. They must have their infrastructure like schools, colleges, hospitals, amenities for the local population for all the visitors. This is called physical connectivity. That's what it shows there, physical connectivity. In the emerging knowledge era, the native knowledge has to be preserved and enhance the latest roots of knowledge, training and research. The villages have to have access to good education. From best teachers, wherever they are, must have the benefit of good medical treatment, must have latest information on their pursuit like agriculture, fishery, horticulture, food processing. That means they have to have electronic connectivity. The first use of physical connectivity is the electronic connectivity. Both the physical and the electronic connectivity are enabled, the knowledge can be enabled. This can facilitate the ability to increase the productivity, the utilization of spare time, awareness of health, welfare, ensuring the market for product, increasing quality conscience, and interacting with partners, getting the best equipment, increase the transparency. So in general, it's called knowledge connectivity. That progress is core competence of the rural environment with additional to technology. Hence, these three connectivities integrated may lead to economic connectivity. What is three connectivities? Physical, electronic, knowledge connectivity are ensured. They facilitate learning capacity leading to economic connectivity. When we provide urban amenities to rural area, we can lead to upliftment of the rural area, we can attract investors, we can introduce effective useful system like rural PPO, microfinance and small scale industries. India will need, in our estimate, for 600, we have got 600,000 villages, 70% of our people live there. So India will need about 7,000 rural complexes with four connectivities, which I have discussed. There are a number of operations in our country, initiated by many educational, healthcare institutions, industry and other institutions. Government of India is already moving ahead with the implementation of Pura on the national scale across the several districts of India. The CIRDAP nation, with over 1.3 billion rural population, also needs to develop over 10,000 Pura. 10,000 Pura complexes across its various member states, each based on their respective core competencies. Let me discuss some model of Pura in CIRDAP nations. I will discuss one Pura model Western India from Indian experience. Another proposed Pura in Kulna, Bangladesh, and another Pura in Kalam Islands in Philippines. So three, one Philippines, one Bangladesh, one for India. First, I will discuss about a unique Pura-based cooperative structure which has come up in western state of Maharashtra in India, is called Varna Pura. A cooperative movement involving the sugarcane farmers and also brought in the